Good morning, fellas. How's going on? I'm just collecting this 7.5 tonner joke. It's a joke, mate. If you see the size of it, you're gonna laugh. Okay, now, so it's another work. Just gonna insert the card in. Oh, lovely. Lovely jaffle. So now entry edition. Yeah. Yeah. Today on 7 o'clock, but this one is on 8 o'clock. So I'm just gonna put 8 on here. Because no one done it. I'm not gonna do it now, yeah. So from 8 o'clock I was on break. 8 o'clock meaning 7 o'clock, yeah? So what I've done until now? I've done other work, yeah? Other work. Select, okay. Begin country, UK, okay. Confirm entry, okay. Now we just have to wait until the card, it will get loaded up. So what I'm doing now, putting the lights on. Safety belt on, safety belt on, yeah. Where is the fucking, just goes here somewhere, yeah. And now you see there is someone in the back with the forklift. I just have to wait for him as well. So I've got enough fuel to go in the yard. He's just around the corner, so it's not bad after all. Just waiting for this car to get loaded up. Just making some noise for some reason, I don't know why. Yeah, mate, so the car is loaded. So, hazard lights on. Yeah. We're gonna go out from this yard, yeah? Yeah, I've just asked those people if they need class 2 drivers. And at the minute they've got their own drivers, so from what they told me, they didn't call up any agencies to find some workers. So probably March or April is gonna be the right time to apply for a job with them. To be fair, working with Bitfood will not be so bad. You know, I've been working on a food delivery company, and will be a pleasure to do this, especially that if I'll get a driver's mate with me, that will make my my life even better. So all I need to do now is just go out of this yard. Yeah, thank you. Always say thank you to the security guy, because it's nice to show your respect. So If you did remember about this lorry, I just dropped this last time I've been on air. So now I'm just picking this up. I'm just gonna drive it back to our yard. Drive it back. So at the minute I'm just in Salford, and I was thinking to apply with this company in the future. And to see how the things will go. Until the end of March, I've got the job guarantee, so I will not struggle. I just completed a little bit of my CV, and it's not done yet 100%. I just have to cut some bits out of it, because it's too long. My CV is like 4 pages, so I need to cut it down. What only good experiences, not like a month job or 2 month job, no, not like that. Like any experience longer than 3 months is welcome to be on my CV. We'll see how the things will go. So the weather, as you see, is not very friendly. It's just pissing down every day.
just raining a lot,
and I don't know when this rain is gonna finish and the sun will show up.
So this one, this lorry is automatic, and it's nice to drive,
easy to drive.
So if you want to become a lorry driver and you want to take step by step,
by taking your C1 license, by taking your 7.5 tonner,
or maybe you've got this grandfather rights, and the only thing you need to do is just to apply for the CPC, to finish your CPC, and then you can drive this straight away. Because even if it's so small, it requires a taco car, okay? Because the weight is on 7.5 ton. So basically what is exceeding 3.5 tons requires a taco machine, yeah? So you will need to have a taco car to drive this one. And why I am saying this, that is really easy to drive compared to other larger vehicles, because the first of all is the size of it, yeah? Secondly, it's about the gearbox, which is automatic, and it's quite fast when it's empty, as it's now, and because it's not so high either, you can go to different places that with a class 2 vehicle will be impossible, or a class 1, let's just say. So by driving this one, you'll gather enough experience to go further, yeah? Never forget that a few years ago I used to drive something like this, yeah? And just a year ago, 2 years ago, I started to work for a food delivery company, Watts Farms, if you heard about it. It's based in Kent now. So they've had vehicles similar with this one, but little bit longer. So it's not bad, mate, it's not bad. As I told you, it was like 27 grand plus 2 grand bonus, 29 grand you'll get by driving this. I guess it's not bad. And I think you'll not have so much stress on your shoulders. If you got a vehicle like this, a small one, and then you'll be lucky enough to get the tail lift on the back. So if you'll have like a pallet drop, you'll just use your pump truck, you'll take the pallet out, and then you're just gonna deliver it, you know? So that's a lot easier than a vehicle without tail lift. I do remember an experience in London. One day I had to replace another guy because he was calling on sick. So I didn't know his run either, so I just needed to do like 17 or 18 customers in different places all around London, and I didn't know where to go, I didn't know where the stuff has to be placed, either in the fridge or on the floor, or either to be signed or anything like that, because that run didn't have any instructions on it. You know why? Because that guy was the only one that knew the run, and everyone else used to refuse that run. So because I was in that company, I was a permanent driver, but also I was a spare driver, because anyone else used to have their own round, and it was me and another guy that didn't have our own run. So to be a spare driver is not bad if you know where you're going, if you know what you're gonna do, you know? But things like that happen. And I just started on that day like 3 o'clock in the morning, supposed to be started, yeah? But the lorry was loaded, the last one, yeah? And guess what time I left here? 5:30. So two and a half hours late I was leaving the yard. So imagine, leave Darfur to go to central London, yeah? On that time, you will have a lot of traffic going on, so that will add even more time on your round, you know? And what I'm trying to say is, if you haven't got a tail lift on the back of your class 2 or a 7.5 tonner and you just need to do pallet drop and all that, mate, it's a pain in the ass, believe me. If you haven't got a tail lift and you just need to take box by box, and I do remember about that 17 or 18 customers, most of them, they used to have like cases of milk. Cases of milk that literally, if you take a box, is not heavy at all to carry by hand, yeah, or to put it on the trolley. But when it's about a pallet full of milk and you needed to do few trips, or maybe more than few trips, you just need to go like 7-8 times in the same place delivering, yeah, and then you'll have your vehicle parked somewhere where it should not be parked, yeah. So then you'll get a ticket, you'll get fined for that, yeah, for parking in the wrong place. Then you need to hurry up, then your office is gonna call you, like it happened with me. The office used to call me all the time, where are you, where are you, the customer is waiting for you, this, that, that. I say, mate, if you give me this vehicle instead of giving to me like 3 o'clock in the morning, should be loaded, strapped, secured, everything with fuel in it. Ah, another thing, it didn't have any fuel in it, so I needed to stop on the petrol station as well. So this adds even more time, yeah? Yes, mate. And they was keep complaining. Ah, you're late, the customer is waiting for you, and this and that. I say, mate, I do apologize, but it's not my fault that the lorry was loaded 5:30 in the morning and then no fuel in it. Why I was supposed to put the fuel in my lorry and then someone else is using it, and then when I have to use a different one, then it doesn't have any fuel in it. You understand what I'm saying? Like, it's really bad, mate, really bad when it happened like that. So I'm pretty sure if you watch this video, and you'll feel like I was how I was feeling long time ago, yeah, because the main thing is there are people that doesn't care about any other of their mates, they just care about their belly to grow bigger and bigger and bigger, you know, but doesn't give a fuck about the people that work very hard and they've got devotion. So that was a reason, that was one of the reasons that I left that company, because I just demonstrate myself I'm capable to do any of that round, yeah. I demonstrate that, yeah, and everyone was happy with me, apart of two managers or two admin, I don't know what's going on. Every time they had to put the blame on me. Ah, you done that, ah, you done that, you done that, you done that. But they never say, ah, thank you, Robert, congratulate, you done a very good job and all that. Ah, and a part of that, where is my overtime money that I work very hard? I never heard a stupid sentence, a more stupid sentence than this. It says like, ah, Robert, if you want to earn your overtime, you need to work more than 192 hours a month. I never heard about this, mate. Look, at the minute I'm working with this agency, yeah? And doesn't matter if I work a day a week, 5 days a week, 3 days a week or whatever. If I work eight hours today and I will work an overtime of a quarter of an hour, at the end of the week, of the next at the next week, at the end of the day, yeah, I will get paid for that quarter of an hour of overtime. I will get paid for that, mate. But you're telling me like a company which is well known, which is a big company, you don't pay your employees what they should get paid, and you expect them to work overtime, to work harder, to work from 8 bank holidays, you expect them to work 4 of the bank holidays, and you expect them to pay their own tickets, their own fines in the loading bay. I got 3 fines last year. I got 3 fines parking the loading bay when I delivered in the same place for more than 60-70 times. and I never get fined, and I get fined 3 days in a row in delivering and parking my vehicle in the loading bay. How bad is that? And then they expected me to pay for that.